Something tells me that that belongs to that up there. Yeah, there's the rest of it. Down here. And if I think, I may have photographs of when this was still intact. Obviously, that tree branch has interfered with it, pushed it over. Happens a lot, unfortunately. So where are we today, people? We are in Vaughan, the city of Vaughan in York Region. This used to be called Elder Mills. And actually, just down over there, way down over there, is the family grave of the Elder family, who the area was named for. And this is Knox Presbyterian Church Cemetery. You'll have to excuse the noise because I'm right on a major road, but we're here to take a look at some of the old headstones, some of the original burials of the pioneers that settled this area, and tell you a little bit about the history. Not sure how well you can see this, but it says, "To the glory of God and in loving memory of Norman Fleming Stanley Cecil Worrell, John William Ward, John MacDonald, W. Beaton, McCalvery, that's McGilvery, sorry, who fell in the Great War, Knox Church, Vaughan." All local men who volunteered. There's a cairn over here we'll go to. So it's also a plaque here with the history on it too. So here we go. Let's see what it says here. Sun is very bright, guys. I'm sorry. Let me get around. It's also a very steamy day. Again, not sure if we can see this here, trying to keep my balance. We got an image here of what the church must have looked like. Knox Presbyterian Church, Vaughan. Brick church was erected on this site in 1883, replacing a frame structure built in 1854. A once active congregation worshipped here for many, many years, but the passing of time and the relocating of many members of the congregation, the church was closed in 1961. In 1973, ownership of the church and the cemetery was transferred to the town of Vaughan. Following year, the building was completely gutted by fire. Restoration of the lower portion of the building was undertaken in 1975, but progressive deterioration eventually compelled the town council, with regret, to demolish the structure and erect in its place this memorial cairn. And that was erected in December of 1983 by the town, then town of Vaughan, which is now the city of Vaughan. And here we have over here the original plaque. Commemorating the church itself, organized in 1845, closed in 1961, the building destroyed by fire October 22nd, 1974. And that building was built in 1883. There's the lintel stone right there. And some of the old headstones from the original cemetery. So the church was probably, I bet you a lot of this stone here is from the original church building that stood just at the back here. So here we are at the back here. This is probably where the church building initially stood. It's held up quite well. There's no sinking of foundations. Usually you find a pit in some of these cemeteries. But I'm guessing, because there's no headstones here, and there doesn't appear to be any graves, that this is where the building actually stood at one point in time up until 1973. This is an interesting one. The draped, broken column with the wreath. Mourning. Yes. That's McKinnon. 1858. Some fairly old. It's also some recent burials in here too. They still do interments in here if this family plot. I wonder if that one for Hamilton Macmillan there is missing the urn at the top. It's usually the case. There's one down there with the urn on. There's another one here. I bet you it's missing its urn. Boy, it's a warm one today, guys. It really is. Let's go stand in the shade and I'll tell you a little bit more about this place. Cameron. A lot of good Scots names here, and there's a reason for it, because it's Presbyterian. Okay, let's go in the shade. Well, I hope my camera doesn't fall over. You wouldn't believe the hassle I had setting it up. Time to get a new tripod, I think. So anyway, today I brought you to Knox Presbyterian Church Cemetery. And as I just showed you in the previous videos, the church was destroyed by fire in 1973 and was established in the late mid-1840s. Now, its first minister actually came to Canada, Upper Canada, in the late 1830s. His name was William McNaughton. And he's not buried here, but he is buried in Maple in his own private plot, which is now located in the middle of a cul-de-sac in a subdivision, the McNaughton family grave plots there. He was here for about 7 years when he was sent back to Scotland because of the Reformation of the Church of Scotland. There was what they call a disruption, which basically was the newer congregations here in Upper Canada no longer wanted really to be part of the Church of Scotland. They didn't want their services in Gaelic anymore. They wanted them in English. They felt that they shouldn't have to be part of the Church of Scotland because they were so far away from there. And these became what they then called successionist churches. So if you're ever here in Southern Ontario and you see old Presbyterian churches using the title Second Presbyterian Church or Successionist, these are the ones that split away from the original Church of Scotland, which later became, of course, the Presbyterian Church of Canada. Now, this cemetery was turned over to the town of Vaughan after the church closed. It's not a very big cemetery. It's actually quite small, and there's one or two modern burials in here. I think the latest one, there's actually a couple of graves with no inscriptions on yet, so, and they're double plots, so, you know, there's people still going to be buried here. Last burial, I think, was about 2000, so yes, people are still being buried here, so if you do come to the cemetery, just keep that in mind. It's in the stewardship of the city of Vaughan. They're responsible for the maintenance. They're the ones that put up that cairn I showed you. And they actually, for the most part, take very good care of their heritage landscapes. And this is no exception. Grass is a little bit long right now, but, you know, for the most part, it's very, very well maintained. So, yeah, let's just walk around and take a look at some of the older headstones that are over in the area. This won't be a very long video because, as I said, it's not a very big cemetery. The squirrels galore in this place as well. Excuse the traffic, the road is just over there, and it's a busy one today because it's Saturday. All right, let's go take a walk. So here we are. This is the family marker for David Elder and his family, his wife Jane Irvine. He died in 1901. He was born in Quebec in 1838, it says, and his wife was born in Scarborough Township in 1838 as well. This is who the area is named for, Elder Mills. And we have some recent, when I say recent, this is the 1980s, 1917 to 1984, 1917 to 1988. Obviously descendants of David and his wife Jane. There's also McClure. That's another very, very popular or well-known name in this area as well. Longhouse, McMurtry. Yeah, and these two headstones here, these are relatively new. So these are, when I say relatively new, they probably replaced original headstones, and there's going to be probably somebody else buried here as well. So Yeah, it's a little hard to stand here. So take a look here. A little Zinke monument over there. As you can see, that's it. It's not a very big area whatsoever. One or two old headstones way in the bushes there, but I'm not going to go down there. That's actually goes down towards the Humber River down there. But yeah, so this is Knox Presbyterian Church. I'll probably put some notes up in the post edit. Knowing me, I would have forgotten something because last time I was here was in 2009. And I took a bunch of still pictures. Here's this little Zinke. It's in very good shape. It's just tilting a little, but otherwise it's all in one piece. Looks like it's for the Fenwick family from Scotland. Yeah. Let's go around the other side. Yeah, you can see down here a little bit of damage. It's bowing a bit. They've reinforced the base in concrete to try and... Sorry about that. It's trying to keep it upright. In memory of Reverend Thomas Fenwick, died 1905 age. He's more than likely one of the many pastors of this congregation. Just take a look around the other side here. Their only child, Thomas Fenwick. Oh, set up by their only child, Thomas Fenwick. So he survived. Very nice, very nice. Still intact, that's the main thing. All right. I thought I'd come down here and just do a quick video of this place. It's well kept, but again, you got a lot of noise here because this is now a main road. It wasn't when I first came down here. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little tour today, a little video to put up on the channel. I'm still trying to try and get you to Toronto Mount Pleasant, but understand we've had some really hot temperatures here in southern Ontario. And really, I don't really want to be walking around a cemetery when it's that hot. Not a cemetery like Toronto and Mount Pleasant, because there's just so much to see and I just wouldn't be able to do it. So hopefully in the next couple of weeks as temperatures cool. It'd be nice to go down in the fall because the trees all turn and it looks really beautiful down there. So hopefully in another couple of weeks when the temperatures are a little bit more conducive to me, I can't do hot weather anymore. So this is Sharon. Hope you liked the little tour I gave you today of Knox Presbyterian in Vaughan, Ontario. You know the rules. Take only pictures, leave only footprints, and if you come down here, please be respectful. So, bye-bye for now.